When it comes to joy, are you getting an incomplete grade? Hey friends, it's Pastor Mike from Fellowship Church. Always good to connect with you. Hope you know that we love you and we're praying for you. Hope you really enjoyed that beautiful weekend that we just had. That question for you again. When it comes to the topic of joy, are you getting an incomplete grade? Thought sticks in my mind because we just came through the first marking period and of course kids are getting report cards and conferences and all that. I want to share a movie with you today if you like to watch movies a bit. There's a movie that's been out about 15 years now. It's called The Pursuit of Happiness. You'll notice the title because they spelled the word happiness wrong. That's intentional. It's part of the movie. Lead character is named Will Smith. You probably know Will Smith. His son is played by his son in real life. And Will Smith plays the role of Chris Gardner. Now, Chris Gardner, if you're not familiar with his story, was a homeless gentleman, struggled with unemployment, single father, wife left him. And he and his son just really struggled to have any kind of a decent living in the city in which they were living. And they lived in restrooms and in bus terminals and other places. It was just an awful thing that he was dealing with, trying to sell sewing machines and other things. And then he got a job as an intern, meaning not making a whole lot of money, at a financial services firm. And then he seems to do pretty well at selling securities and stocks and those kind of things. And at the very end of the movie, when his internship is done and he thinks that they're all going to wave goodbye and see you later, thanks a million for all your work, they decide to hire him. He has his first meaningful job. And if you remember the end of the movie, if you've seen it, that scene of Will Smith leaving that place where he's been the intern, thought for sure his work was done, he's off to the next whatever he had, that scene of him stepping out onto the street, knowing that his life was now different, and he's celebrating in this crowd of people, and he runs to the place where his child is receiving daycare and grabs his child and hugs him. I mean, just that beautiful scene where he is so overwhelmed with, well, let's just call it joy, or maybe they could call it happiness. But I have a question for you. Have you ever had a moment like that in your spiritual life? Have you ever had a moment like that where you've been so overwhelmed by all that God has done for you, and by the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross to save us from our sins and now desires to live in us and wants to live through us and continues to forgive us day by day and showers us with blessings. Have you ever had a moment where you just kind of took all that in and it literally brought a tear to your eye and you wanted to stand in a crowd of people who might all be oblivious to what's happened to you and for you and you wanted to just cheer? There's that moment where Will Smith is just like, this, so exuberant with joy because of the new life that he now has and the chance that's been taken. The Chris Gardner story is a great story. Go follow that sometime if you'd like to. But I wonder if anything like that has ever happened to you spiritually, or if you've ever had a raw moment where you just recognized everything that God has done for you and you felt like cheering in public. Friends, there's a passage in John chapter 15, last night of his life, Jesus with his disciples, he says to them that he wants his joy to be in them, meaning he's transplanting his joy in them, and then he says, and I want my joy to be complete in you. Friends, if you've never had that moment where you wanted to just sing to the heavens over what had been done for you and the acceptance and the affirmation you received, well, friends, maybe your joy's incomplete. If you've never taken inventory of all that God's done for you and just given him praise for it, maybe your joy's incomplete. If you've never been overwhelmed by this incredible sense of gratitude, well, friends, maybe your joy's incomplete. And if Jesus Christ hasn't really changed your life yet, well, maybe it's because your joy is incomplete. Christ Jesus wants you to be aware of all that he's done for you. He wants you to feel his joy to the very depth of your soul, and he wants you to cry off the mountaintops in gratitude to the God who saved you and changed your life. Friends, may your joy be fully complete, and may you experience what Chris Gardner experienced in that chapter of his life, to stand in a crowd of people and just clench his fists and be so overwhelmed with gratitude. May you have moments like that in your life as well. I hope you have a wonderful week. Hope you know that we love you and we're praying for you. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.